We'll now have the third part of the action research proposal, proposed innovation, intervention, and strategy. Describe the action that you will do in order to solve your identified practical problem. A literature review would help you a lot in choosing and deciding on the intervention or strategy to use. Though action research is not conducted to fill the gap in the literature, adapting strategies from literature to solve a similar problem would be helpful. You may also discuss the issue with your co-teachers who experience the same in his or her class. Sharing of thoughts, opinions, and experiences would lead you to better understanding of the problem. Most action researches are reactive, which means that the researchers employ intervention in order to solve a felt problem. With the existing situation as the baseline, you decide on solution. Most of the time, you adopt some strategies proven effective by previous researchers, which you believe will help address your identified problem. Some action researchers are innovative, which means the researcher would like to formulate his or her own strategy as an innovation and would test their effectiveness. Nevertheless, regardless of the nature of the intervention, clearly describe what intervention strategy that will be employed, who will be involved, as well as activities that will be undertaken. Include also the rationale, extent, and limitation of the intervention, innovation, or strategy. This part generally focuses on the what of the action research. Example, as an intervention to the emerging problem on the alarming numbers of learners and frustration level, this study will utilize mental models like pictures and videos as aid on reading comprehension. The participants of the study will be subjected to a daily class session utilizing reading materials with picture counterpart or video counterpart for 1 hour during school days, to be facilitated by the teacher researcher for 3 months. There will be a weekly reading assessment to be conducted using Fili-ERI tools in order to measure the progress of the learners. The weekly progress of the readers and frustration level will be recorded using the tracking of weekly progress template. That ends the third episode of our webinar series 2020. Thank you for watching, and I am inviting all of you to like and follow the Facebook page and subscribe to the YouTube channel of Planning and Research section.